going to determine the wavelength of the semiconductor laser. So for that need, the apparatus required are the laser source, grating table, and then grating, laser student's grating, and the screen. Okay, so first we are going to determine the wavelength of the semiconductor laser. So this is the laser source. Okay, so from that laser source, so the laser is coming out and it is passing on the diffraction, student's diffraction grating. It is diffracted and the light are diffracted, which is obtained in the photographic plate, that is screen here. Okay, you see here. This apparatus is the laser source, grating, and then screen. So formula used is wavelength of the laser is given by lambda is equal to sine theta by n. Theta, angle of diffraction for laser, degree. N is the number of lines per unit length of the grating, which is lines per meter. Here we are using the grating, number of lines should be 6 into 10 to the power 5 lines per meter. Okay, so if you see the diagram, so this is the laser source, this is the grating table, okay, grating, and then the laser, from the laser source the light is coming out of the laser source and it is diffracted by means of a grating and the light is fall on the photographic plate. The central line, which is called as the direct ray, and these two x1 and x2 lines, which is called first order diffracted ray. When you switch on the laser, there will be only one ray, that is direct ray only we will get. When you place the grating, we will get the diffracted ray. These are the first order diffracted rays. Okay, we will go into measure the distance between the grating and the, this is the grating, this is the screen, distance between the grating and the screen, and then we have to measure the distance between the central spot and the first order diffracted ray, to the left, to the right, and to the left. This is the tabulation for the wavelength of the laser. So first tabular column, first column, distance between the grating and the screen, that is D. Second one is distance between the central point and the left side point, x1. Distance between the central point and right side point, x2. So x is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2. Sin theta is equal to x divided by square root of x square plus this D square. So for the first reading, so distance between the grating and the screen. So first we fix the distance between the grating and the screen. So we are fixing the distances here, it will be at 12. So the grating will be fixed at 12. So it starts from 0 here. So it should be, the distance is 12. So D is 12 here. So next is the distance between the central point and the left side point. So distance between the central point and the first left side of the first order point, so it should be around, so 5.3, so 5.3 it should be distance between central point and the first left point. So our next column is the distance between the central point and the right side point. It is nearly equal to 5. So it is 5 here. So next, x is equal to x1 plus x2 by 2. So you have to add and divide it by 2 here. And sin theta is equal to x. This mean this x value divided by square root of x square plus d square. So d is here 12. So 12 squared, you put the value and do the calculation here. For the second reading, we adjust the grating table to the 14. So we adjust the grating table to the 14. So and then same procedure should be repeated. So central, from the central point to the left side of the left side spot, you take the reading, and then central point to the right side point, you measure the distance and write it in the table. The same procedure is repeated for the 14, 16 and 18. Likewise, the distance should be changed. If the distance should be varied of the grating table, you can see the size of the distance between the central spot and the first order ray also, distance should be increased. Okay, so from this variation, so we can find it in the calculation part. Take 5 set of readings, the same should be repeated. So and then find the sine theta value for the 5 readings and take the mean value. So substitute this mean value to the formula lambda is equal to sine theta. That mean value sine theta should be substituted here, divided by n. N is 6 into 10 to the power 5 lines per meter. You substitute the n value here and you will get the wavelength of the laser source. That should be written in the result, wavelength of the given laser lambda value.